Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. First of all, I would like to emphasize that all the things I'm telling you in this video, in the previous videos I have done, are based on real VUBB entrance exam taking experience of myself. I took the exam in 2019, and if you can count very basic numbers, I am in my third year of VUBB studies, and if everything goes smoothly, I am going to be graduating this summer. And the experience of my students whom I tutored for the Vienna University of Economics and Business for the Bachelor of Business Economics at the University of the Ingolstadt program in 2020 and 2021. In both of those years, the VUBB entrance exam was online due to the pandemic and COVID restrictions, and VU has officially announced on the info sessions that the VUBB entrance exam will always be online regardless of what happens with the pandemic, because it's more convenient, especially for those people, for those international people who have to come to Vienna for just 2 or 3 days and have to, well, it costs them quite a lot of money to come to Vienna for just to take the entrance exam. So to solve that problem, VU has decided to make the entrance exam online for everyone. And somewhere on the website it says, well, the statistics say that 70% of all people applying to VUBB are international students, so that makes perfect sense. Without further ado, I would like to get in the core of this video, and its topic is Plan B. Plan B is really important for two main reasons. First of all, it decreases your stress levels on the actual entrance exam date, the university you want to get in, which is like your first choice. And I'm assuming since you're on this channel, your first choice is VUBB. So it will decrease your stress levels. And as experience shows, the less stressed you are, the more points you get and the higher chances you get of getting accepted. And the second reason is, what if you get into an oopsies situation? That happened not quite often, but it happened, especially with the online exam, when it's unpredictable. There are some factors which you cannot prevent, you cannot foresee them. For example, if your Wi-Fi goes off, if the platform just doesn't work on the entrance exam day, if you cannot see the questions at all, and so on. So imagine you're in a situation where you prepared for the exam, you prepared well for it, you have the knowledge base to maybe pass it and maybe even get accepted, but it just doesn't work. The computer, something happens which is out of your control, and you sit there on your chair in front of your computer and thinking to yourself, well, what do I do now? And when you start checking other universities, their websites and information about that, you see that the registration is closed. Some universities have already announced who is accepted to them, and so on. And it all just becomes a mess and panic and stress. And that's something you want to avoid at all costs, especially when it's something important as university enrollment. So this video, it will be very, very relevant for those who are finishing high school this year and for those people to whom it's important for any reasons to get accepted this year. So they want to get accepted in their respective year in this year. So this video comes up in October, so well, you have a year still to go until summer, where most enrollments take place, and they just need to get accepted to a university, to a bachelor program. I will provide you with some plan Bs, which are comparable, so are more on the same level of knowledge, programs, also geographical locations to VUBB. So that those universities in Austria, and those universities are mostly public ones, so which don't have, well, over the sky high fee costs, high tuition fee costs. And I will be posting about those universities on this YouTube channel separately. I know students from most of the universities I'm going to talk about here, and I'm planning to travel to them and maybe get an interview and so on. So I would really suggest you subscribe to the channel now, not to miss out any of those videos, because they will be kind of live and you will get instant information and so on. And let's get into the options. So the three main options, which are close to Vienna, where they're in Austria, and I know people from there who got accepted and have started their studies there right now actually, is Lauder Business School in Vienna. There is an English bachelor program which is related to business and economics. But there it's like you have kind of not subjective, but the criteria of getting accepted there can vary. And it goes from an essay to an interview, so you can get rejected at any of those two steps. So it shouldn't be your only plan B, it should be like one of the plan Bs you have. Then you have two universities who are in the top rank of Austrian universities. It's Alpen Adria Universität in Klagenfurt, and they offer a new program related to business and economics. And the entrance procedure there is an entrance exam with math and economics kind of mixed together. They also provide you with literature for it. So the exam is pretty chill, pretty nice. And people said that it's easier than the BB entrance exam, especially after preparing for it with my course or by themselves. They were like, wow, that exam was so easy. It was like a piece of cake after everything we had to learn for the VUB entrance exam. Then there is also the Johannes Kepler University in Linz. And it also offers a relatively new program related to business economics bachelor program in English. I mean, there's like a trend, I think, right now of English bachelor programs for business economics all around, maybe the world, especially in Austria, who noticed that. And then just procedure there is a video of yourself, like your motivations to get into the university, and I think then an essay, which you have to check the details for, like the topics you need to write about and so on, and be very attentive reading the emails with instructions about that essay. And yeah, so as my students said that there were 80 places available for that program and only 94 applicants. So, well, the chances were pretty high that you will get accepted. So these are the three main options I know a lot of stuff about, and you can also shoot me a message on my Instagram, which will be in the description box below, about any questions you have about those universities. Check their websites, and I will kind of link all the webs, all the unis I mentioned right now in the description box in case I missed any important details. So always check the official websites, please. And then there is also Fachhochschule, and it offers several programs related to business economics and also some in English, some in German. And the fee is similar, the tuition fee is similar to VU, which is, well, not very high. And so the fee for VU is like 20 euros per semester, so per half a year for European citizens, and around 750 euros, somewhere around that, for non-EU citizens per half a year. So that's a very, very affordable and high quality education you can get there. Then you have the private universities, which cost more, of course, and they will have high tuition fees. But if you have the financial means, why not? The two main ones, I think, are Webster University and Modul University, and please check their prospective programs for that. I also have like a highlight in my Instagram, which is called like Plan B, and there's a description of each of the university there. A student who lives in Austria and who applied to some of the universities made like a selection of them, and I'm really grateful to her. So this information comes from like first source student who lives there, from like a local person, so well, she knows the deal. And yeah, there's, I think, are those are kind of the main options I would like to tell you about, which are related to bachelor programs in English in Austria. And also there is another option, which, well, will give you like some bonus points, like some bonus skills, I would say, is learning German. So in case you don't get accepted to the preferred program, if you have at least an A2 level of German, you can have the certificate for it to prove it, you can enroll into language courses where you need to where you have 2 years to learn German to a C1 level, and maybe take any supplementation examination to make your schooling certificate equal to the Austrian one if you will be applying to the German taught programs, because that's logical. If you're applying to a German taught program in Austria, that means your schooling certificate has to also somehow correlate with the Austrian typical high schooling certificate. So sometimes universities tell you to take some extra examinations in geography, history, math, and so on, depending on your bachelor, which you're applying to. And this is a very good plan, backup option, because it's almost certain you're gonna get into those courses. Well, because, well, there is nothing is stopping you apart from an A2 level of German, which is proven by a certificate. And some of the students do that. I know at least, I think, 3 or 4 students who have enrolled into those courses and will begin their studies. And they also will tell me how it is, how the kind of selection procedure goes, and how the exam held there, which determines to which group you will go, like regarding your German level, and so on. So if you have any further questions, please contact me on Instagram, and I will help you with everything I can. And by now, after a lot of experience in that kind of ocean of education in Austria, I have quite a lot of inside information to tell you. So thank you for listening, and please remember that statistics say if you're going to go to VUBB, that the chances of you getting accepted, there is always 10 to 20% of people who apply who get accepted. So please take care of your plan B. One university, in any scenario, should not be your only option. Maybe search for maybe some universities in your home country, why not, just in case. So you don't lose the year in case you absolutely need to get accepted to some university. So not to be frustrated, not to cry, not to have a panic attack, maybe please take care of it all now. Watch the websites, look at the websites the universities have, their entrance procedure, the deadlines, so that when summer comes, you don't run around and not knowing what to do, and you have a pretty nice plan which minimizes your stress. And all the best to you, wish you good luck, and I really hope and I know that this year is going to be very important for most of you who are finishing high school, and will determine probably, well, at least a couple of years of your future and your academic career. See you, subscribe to the channel, and all the details will be in the description down below.